This is a chapter from section C of the ISC syllabus. सबसे पहले हम बात करेंगे covariance की. So these chapters are typically formula oriented. Formula अगर हमें याद है हम आसानी से sum कर सकते हैं. Formula याद नहीं है तो हमें sum करने में दिक्कत होगी. बात करते हैं covariance और covariance of x and y. First of all, write down the definition. What is the meaning of the word covariance? So it stands for the mean of the product of deviation xi minus x bar and yi minus y bar is called the covariance of x and y. Simple logic. The mean of the product, mean का मतलब divided by n करते हैं, याद रखना. किसी भी चीज का mean निकालते हैं, मतलब we divide the entire thing by the total number of observation. So the mean of the product of deviation, this and this, is called the covariance of x and y. So how do we write the formula? Capital C x y is equals to summation of x minus x bar into y minus y bar, that thing will whole divided by capital N. This is the formula we have. Yahan pe meaning of the various terms, x bar, of course, it signifies mean of x. Y bar, it signifies mean of y. And how do we find mean of x? Summation x by total number of observation. Mean of y, summation y by total number of observations. So इस फॉर्मूले से हमारा जो वैल्यू आएगा, इस वैल्यू को हम बोलेंगे कोवेरियंस. कोवेरियंस के लिए हमारे पास सिर्फ एक फॉर्मूला नहीं है. इसी फॉर्मूले की जगह अगर हम एक और सिंप्लीफाइड फॉर्मूला यूज करना चाहें तो वी मे यूज दिस ऑल्सो. इट इज 1 बाई एन ब्रैकेट में वी हैव समेशन एक्स वाई माइनस 1 बाई एन समेशन एक्स समेशन वाई. I'm repeating myself once again. Do not ask how this it come. Ye formula aaya kaise, derive kaise hua. All this is immaterial. Formula yaad, hum chapter section C jo hai, 15 on 15 we can target. 15 on 15 hum score kar sakte hain. Pichle saal tak section C se 20 marks ke question aate the, but this year, COVID year, they have reduced down the pattern and you will be asked 15 mark ke question from section C. Aur wo asaan hai score karna if we memorize all the formula. So, दो फॉर्मूले हमने देखे. ये दो फॉर्मूले हमें कब यूज करने हैं इसको नोट डाउन कर लो. दैट दिस टू फॉर्मूले टू बी यूज्ड व्हेन वी हैव एक्स एंड वाई वैल्यूज आर स्मॉल या एक्स एंड वाई हैव स्मॉलर वैल्यूज. जब एक्स एंड वाई का वैल्यू छोटा वैल्यू होगा, स्मॉल वैल्यूज होगा, देन वी नीड टू यूज दिस फॉर्मूला. स्मॉल वैल्यूज एज इन 5, 10, 9, 2, 5, 6 लाइक दैट वैल्यूज. अगर इस टाइप के वैल्यूज हैं तब हम क्या तो ये फॉर्मूला यूज करेंगे या ये फॉर्मूला यूज करेंगे, डिपेंडिंग ऑन द सिचुएशन. बोथ विल गिव यू द सेम आंसर. बट इफ यू हैव एक्स एंड वाई वैल्यूज लिटिल लार्जर लाइक 19, 29, 30, 50 काइंड ऑफ, उस टाइम पे हम कोवेरियंस का एक नया फॉर्मूला यूज करेंगे. दैट एवरीथिंग रिमेन्स द सेम, जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट द टर्म्स. इंस्टेड ऑफ समेशन एक्स वाई यू राइट समेशन यू वी minus 1 by n. Instead of summation x, you write summation u. Instead of summation y, you write summation v. This becomes the new formula. And this to be used, specifically used, when you have x and y have larger values. X and y have larger values. So this formula to be used only when you have x and y values little complicated, larger. X ka koi value observations. X matlab basically we are talking about observations under the column X. Y means y observations under the column Y. Agar wo complicated data dikhega, 49, 57, 19, thoda sa easy nahi hai, us time pe we will use this. Now comes the question, what is the meaning of U? U ka matlab hoga X minus capital A aur V ka matlab hoga Y minus capital B. Now what is this capital A and capital B? तो याद रखेंगे, कैपिटल ए का मतलब है assumed mean. When we take a question, you will get to know what is the meaning of this term. Assumed mean in x column, and even y, b ka matlab hoga, assumed mean in the y column. Y observation में से अपने मन से एक parameter हम consider करेंगे, x में से consider करेंगे जिसको capital A नाम देंगे, और y में से consider करेंगे जिसको capital B नाम देंगे, और अपने column को simplify करने की कोशिश करेंगे. इसीलिए ये terms हमने decide किया, that is u is equals to x minus capital A and v is equals to y minus capital B. And specifically, we will be using this formula only we have a complicated scenario. So, these are the three formulas to be used in the very first exercise we have. Let me start with few questions now. Number one, find the covariance between x and y when summation x is equals to 50, summation y is equals to minus 30, summation xy is equals to 115, and n value is equals to 10. So find the covariance between x and y when this is the data given to us. Which formula we can use? Directly the first formula. First formula use kar sakte hain, ya let us say second formula use karenge. More specific. So, kyunki yahan pe mean value hume calculate na karna pade, isliye hum directly second formula use karenge. Second formula says, covariance of x and y is given by, let us see what is the formula, 1 by n outside the bracket. So, first of all, let us write down the formula. And then we have summation xy minus 1 by n, summation x, summation y. Supply the values. N ka value 10 directly given, bracket open. Summation xy just 115 minus 1 by 10. Summation x is 50 multiplied by summation y, it is minus 30. Now let us evaluate and tell me the answer. On calculation, we are getting 26.5. This is the first answer. Simple question, no complication involved. Number two. Find covariance of x and y for the following data. And data may they have given us a tabular column like this. In this tabular column, they have given us two columns, x and y. And under x, we have values like 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And here we have 8, 7, 6, 5, and 4. The question is simple, that we need to find covariance of x and y. ये covariance को हमने capital C x y denote किया, इसको हम C O V x y भी denote कर सकते हैं like this. ठीक है? It signifies the same. Solution aspect की बात करें तो सबसे पहले हम formula लिखेंगे, और formula लिखने के पहले हम judge करेंगे कि ये जो x and y का values है, are they bigger values or they are smaller values? And we can see that they are not too much of complicated values. Simple values are 3, 4, 8, 7, single digit values. Matlab, once again, we can make use of the second formula, which says covariance xy is equals to, and every single time write the formula so that you can memorize it. Summation xy minus 1 by n, summation x, summation y. So, is logic se hame pata chala that we need to formulate one more column. और उस कॉलम का नाम क्या होगा? उस कॉलम का नाम होगा xy. ये हमारा सॉल्यूशन स्टार्ट हो चुका है क्वेश्चन का. That column name should be xy. xy means you need to multiply the x and the y corresponding values. 3 into 8 will give us 24. 7 4s are 28. 6 5s are 30. Then once again 30, and then we have 28. After having done, now what we have to obtain? We have to add all the x values, which will give us summation x, we have to add all the y values, which will give us summation y, and we have to add all the third column values, which will give us summation xy. We will get this term, we will get this term, we will get this term. And how about this capital N? Capital N signifies number of observation. So if you count 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, so N value is basically 5. We have been provided by total 5 observations. So in values ko hum put karenge, so 1 by 5, we have 140 here, minus 1 by 5 into 25 multiplied by 30. And on calculation, you will get minus 2 as the required answer. So now third question. Once again, the question is, find covariance X and Y for the following data. Once again, as data, they have given us only two columns, happens to be X and Y. Eleven, twelve, thirteen, fourteen, fifteen, seventeen, eighteen, nineteen, twenty, and twenty-one. Give me 1 minute. Now we'll write the values of Y, which is 14, 8, 12, 21, 19, 19, 23, 22, 17, and 25. Do note down the data efficiently. Do not make a mistake in copying down the data. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, then 17, 18, 19, and 20, 21. And in Y, we have 14, 8, 12, 21, 19, 19, 23, 22, 17, and 25. Is question mein hume calculate karne ke liye diya gaya hai covariance once again. But this time, just by looking into the data, we can understand that data is not simple data. Why not simple? Because imagine multiplying these two values. 15 ko 19 se multiply karenge, we are getting huge values. Isiliye hume kya karna hoga? Is table ko extend karna hoga little more. Solution aspect mein. Aur hum samajh gaye hain ki ye jo data hai, ye simple, smaller data nahi hai. Agar smaller data nahi hai, matlab hamara jo ye formula use hoga, wo hoga the third formula. Jahan pe sabse pehle hum u and v ka value calculate karna chahenge, because we want to change the variable. X and Y के ऊपर कोई काम नहीं होगा, काम होगा U and Y के, V के ऊपर. But U का formula अगर recall करोगे, the formula was X minus A and V का formula है Y minus B. मतलब, before we proceed anything, we need to first identify what is A and B. A और B को हमने कहा था assumed mean. A का मतलब assumed mean in the column of X. और generally, how do we find assumed mean? हम क्या करते हैं, हम पूरे के पूरे एक कॉलम को, मतलब जो फर्स्ट कॉलम है एक्स का, उसको एनालाइज करेंगे और उसका सेंटर मोस्ट वैल्यू, द मिडिल मोस्ट वैल्यू विल बी कंसीडर्ड. इट इज अ अज्यूम्ड मेथड. अज्यूम्ड मीन मतलब अपने मन से कुछ लेना. यू फील लाइक टेकिंग सम रैंडम वैल्यू, यू कैन टेक. आई फील लाइक टेकिंग सम रैंडम वैल्यू, आई कैन टेक. बट स्टिल दे हैव डिसाइडेड वन थंब रूल एंड व्हिच सेज दैट जनरली व्हाट वी विल डू दैट वी विल लुक फॉर अ मिडिल मोस्ट वैल्यू, मतलब सेंटर मोस्ट वैल्यू. लेट अस से अगर इस x के कॉलम को एनालाइज करो, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have 10 values. इसके सेंटर में दो वैल्यू आ रहे हैं, this and this. दो वैल्यू है 15 and 17. अपने मन से हम कुछ भी ले सकते हैं. अगर तुम चाहो तो 15 and 17 का मिड पॉइंट लेना चाहो, तो even you can do that. So let us do only that. A का वैल्यू हमने क्या किया, 15 और 17 के बीच में कौन आता है, 16. We will consider 16. So it is user choice. अगर हम चाहें 16 लेना, we can take 16. If you want to take 15, we can go for 15. If you want to take 17, we can go for 17. So let us consider the mid value of 15 and 17, which happens to be 16. Matlab, jo hamara pehla column calculate hoga, that u will basically be calculated as x minus 16. In the similar logic, now we want to identify the value of b. One second you have two values at the center aur dono hi 19 hai, which clearly implies b ka value hume kya lena hai, we will take 19. Matlab jo dusra column hum calculate kar rahe hain v, that is y minus 19. Let us go for the calculation. X ka value 11, so this will be 11 minus 16, it will give us minus 5. Similarly, 12 minus 16, it will give us minus 4. So that way, if we directly calculate, the values will be minus 5, minus 4, then minus 3, then minus 2, minus 1. Now 17 minus 16 will give us 1, 18 minus 16, 2, 19 minus 16, 3, 4 and 5. तो अब हम देख पा रहे हैं हमारा जो डेटा है वो सिंपलीफाई हो गया. वी हैड बिगर वैल्यूज, नाउ द यू कॉलम इज गिविंग अस सो सिंपल सिंपल वैल्यूज, सिंगल डिजिट वैल्यूज. इन द सिमिलर पर्सपेक्टिव वी विल नाउ फाइंड वी. वी के लिए हमें क्या करना है, वाई के डेटा को ऑब्जर्वेशन को लेना है और 19 सब्ट्रैक्ट करना है. सो 14 माइनस 19 विल गिव अस माइनस 5, 8 माइनस 19 विल गिव अस माइनस 11, 12 माइनस 19 विल गिव अस माइनस 7, देन 2, देन 0. Then 0. Then we have 4, 3, minus 2, and let us say last value is 6. So finally, we are ready with two values which we wanted, that is u and v. Ye uv wala agar hum formula recall kare, to what was the formula? Covariance is equal to 1 by n summation of uv minus 1 by n summation u summation v. Matlab, we are looking for three terms. Pehla hai summation uv, dusra hai summation u, and teesra hai summation v. Summation u and summation v to hume yahan se mil jayega. What about summation uv? So we still want to find one more value, that is uv. Ab humare paas ek aur column aa gaya, jis column ka naam hoga uv. Now if we multiply, minus 5 minus 5 will give us 25, 44, 21, minus 4, 0, 0, 8, 9, minus 8, and 13. So 25, 44, 21, minus 4, 00, 8, 9, minus 8, and 30. If we add all these values, we will now get summation uv as well. So if we calculate this, we will come across the values. Summation u, it will give us 0. See, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. Sare values ko with their sign, if we add, we will get 0 as the summation u. So first value, summation u is equals to 0. Similarly, if we add up all the summation v values, summation v, we will get summation v is equals to minus 10. And summation uv, that value will be 125. What about capital N? That is this value, number of observation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So N value is 10. We will substitute these values and find out the covariance. So on calculation, we got 12.5 as the required covariance for the third question we did.